saying today you signed up to have a king. You signed up to have a Lord, and his name is Jesus.
Amen.
You claim that you know Jesus. The Bible says if you know him, you will obey his commandments.
Amen.
How can you obey his commandments and follow along with this wicked nation that everybody says God is blessing? God is not blessing you. On the topic of homosexuality, the homosexual is a pestilence in America. The homosexual is given to America as a curse. You think that God is blessing you by allowing a homosexual to move into your neighborhood? You are wrong. You have not the Spirit of God. You have not the Spirit of discernment. Yet, we're not just here for the homosexuals. If you think God is blessing America by allowing your children to be fornicators, you are wrong. If you think God is blessing America to allow you to sit around and drink booze and legalize marijuana, you are wrong. God is angry with the wicked every single day.
What makes America unique is not our politicians. What makes America unique is our founders actually believed in the Bible. Not the Quran, not the Book of Mormon, the Bible. Obama, when he was voted into office, placed his hand on a Bible. The same Bible that says, if you're a homosexual, you're an abomination before God. The same Bible that says, if you're a homosexual, you are a reprobate before God. When you die, you will not be judged by the Constitution. When you die, you will not be judged by the Bill of Rights. When you die, you will not be judged by what's politically correct. You will not be judged by your own emotion or feelings. Everyone will be judged by God's standard. Unlike our Supreme Court that may change its mind over and over, God does not change his mind. You will be judged by God's holy standard.
That is embracing lies. Lies. Or we're going to lose our freedoms. If you can't believe in the truth of the God who gave us our Constitution, how are you going to keep the Constitution? How are you going to keep your rights? When you reject the God that gave you those rights, when you reject the God that gave you those rights, we're going to lose them. When you reject the God that gave you your prosperity, you're going to get poverty. America's going to go into poverty. America's going to slide in the middle of decay, and we're going to lose our freedoms. The police state is coming. Totalitarianism is coming. Tyranny is coming because of your sin. Because you sinned against a holy and righteous God. And he looked down upon you and no longer will bless this nation. He cast Adam and Eve out of the Garden of Eden for one sin, for eating a piece of fruit. What do you think God's going to do to America for having homosexuals?
It's amazing, the only rebuttal they can summon is to kiss each other, as if that substantiates their point. It's unbelievable.
No, he will not. God will not bless a nation that puts two men together and
Amen.
Two women together in perversion. They're acting like animals.
God loves everybody.
And I don't care what you think how much you think your straight friends accept your relationship. You know what happens when you're not around?
That's a line.
When they start thinking about the actual mechanics of what you do,
I'm not sure.
You vomit right something out of the throat. I mean, it's just nasty. Homosexuality is nasty. Homosexuality is disgusting. It's a perversion. It's evil. It's nasty. And it's wrong. That's why you get diseases. You get diseases because that is the judgment of God for your sin. God doesn't have to sit up in heaven and throw lightning bolts at you to judge you. All he has to do is let the natural occurrence of you, natural consequences of you being out of his order, take its full effect. And disease and death are part of those natural consequences. When you do unnatural things, you will receive unnatural consequences. That's what you'll get. But Jesus Christ can deliver you. That's the good news. The bad news is there's evil throughout the land. The fact that this church is even winning.
That's a good attempt, Jeremiah. That was a good attempt. Good attempt.
You're good attempt. You're polluting the Supreme Court of the United States with the false arguments of gay marriage. Them even going in there and talking about it and considering it is fouling up the land. This is a pile of dung and stinks in the nostrils of God.
Amen.
That's what this court is today. A pile of dung and it's a stench in the nostrils of God. Because what they're talking about in there stinks. It's sin. It's nasty. It's evil. It's animalistic. It's unnatural.
Amen.
God calls it in Romans chapter 1 a vile passion. A vile passion. Do you think that sounds like God approves of that? Does that sound like God approves of it when he calls it a vile passion? That's what the court should say. Case dismissed. It's a vile passion. I don't want the judgment of God. Bang! Get out of my court.
The same book that says a lesbian like her is an abomination.
Amen.
There's a walking abomination right there. A reprobate right there.
Amen.
God considers you a reprobate. God is going to put you in the hell. You're telling me he's going to put somebody in hell that he loves? You don't know the God of the Bible, woman. You are clueless as to the God of the Bible. You reject the God of the Bible. You deserve hellfire, woman. You deserve hellfire when you die. You're wicked. Have you noticed that just down the street, Baltimore is burning in flames? Oh, what a symbolic with what's going on in the Supreme Court today.
Oh my God.
Could it possibly be a judgment of God?
Amen.
That right down the freeway we have Baltimore burning down as the Supreme Court wants to hear a case of lesbians getting married?
Amen.
Can it possibly be a judgment of God? Can that possibly be a judgment of God? Kind of like God when he rained down fire from heaven.
Amen.
Because of people like you. Because of people like you. This is what a man looks like, woman. This is what a man looks like. Not like you. You're a scab. You're phony. I walk, I think, I talk, and I act like a man.
Amen.
God intended. Not like you. If you don't know what you are, you need to look what's in between your legs. God bless you with a good yeast infection. Once again, where in the Bible do we find same-sex marriage?
Nowhere.
Where? What example?
Everywhere.
Why did God destroy this Sodom and Gomorrah? What evil did they do to provoke Sodom and Gomorrah to flames? Submit, and you never did.
Amen.
He turned around and
Amen.
And with an attitude like that, you will never attract a man like me in the U.S.
Amen.
Sodom and Gomorrah. Where was this God who had all tolerance and was all forgiving? Where was this God when God destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah? Anybody got an answer to that?
I thought in the Bible they preach loving your neighbor.
We're loving you, Roman.
Amen.
We're loving you right now.
First of all, I'm straight.
I can tell us who you are. If you're with the homosexuals, you're just as guilty. The Bible says, he that justifieth the wicked, and he that condemneth the just,